I am the one they call Nick Shell. And when you are Nick Shell, not if, but when you are Nick Shell, you get a comment on new videos and you feel like, you know what, I need to share this comment. I need to launch this conversation further. I need to extend the life of this conversation. I made a video called Your Hairline Expecting and Accepting Change. Our good friend Maxwell Smart, who is one of my most faithful supporters from the very beginning, from years ago. Here's what he has to say, quote, "You have an advantage over many of your subscribers. You have buzzed off your hair many times since college and shaved it bald this spring. You know how you will look. This makes accepting and expecting change that much easier. The other thing is that you are really not obsessed with having perfect hair. You take of what you have with a low maintenance perspective." And I gotta stop right there. That is a very great analysis of how I feel about hair loss. You know, there are things I could do to maybe make my hair look better. You know, I could have it short on the sides and have more disconnected part, but that's too much. People are like, why don't you use a blow dryer? No. I'm all about low maintenance, and I think that's why for me, my hair's got to either be buzzed off or it's got to be a bit longer so that I don't have to think about it. Even though I'm like, do I think about my hair all the time because of these videos? Well, I mean, I'm not thinking about it for myself. I'm thinking about it for you and all the many notes that I keep with me at all times for future subjects like this one. All right, let's continue the comment. I think that was very well said, though, that I'm not obsessed about having perfect hair. I accept the imperfection of being a human being with hair. Even girls are not happy with their hair. There's a Kenny Chesney song, a new song that talks about that, that ultimately all these girls stand in front of a mirror, none of them are happy. If they're not happy, and yet men bald naturally, most of us are gonna be balding. Why would we need to be happy about our hair? It's not a masculine thing to worry about your hair. It's a female thing to worry about your hair. Wow, that could have been its own video, but I'm gonna keep going. The rest of the comment, quote, "I think many men have a deep fear of going bald that goes beyond expecting and accepting. I think it would be a good question to ask your subscribers in a video, quote, why are you afraid of going bald? And how has hair loss affected you so far?" To which I responded with this, quote, "You are perfectly correct and perhaps you've inspired a new video topic. Fortunately, the answer is easy." And here was my answer to the question, why are you afraid of going bald? And how has hair loss affected you so far? My answer to Max was this, quote, "I fear I won't be able to have sex. And that fear itself keeps my confidence low." So that was my response. It's always been that obvious to me. I have over how many videos? Like 2,400 on this channel at least, 2,500. Most of those being explicitly about hair loss. And based on the comments that come in, guys are afraid that they won't be able to have sex. And the fear of that, not the hair loss itself, the fear of that only confirms their fear and their confidence, and therefore they're less attractive, not simply physically, but psychologically. To me, that's the end of the video. Cut, done. But we'll extend this even more. All right, so the next part I want to take a look at is, he rebutted, our good friend Max had this to say, quote, "Yes, those are easy ones, but are they the truth? I think it's the fear of the unknown. Will people still like me, or will they laugh at me? Will I find a mate? Can I get a good job and be successful? Yes, these do have a lot to do with self-confidence, but they are more personal," end quote. To which I responded one more time and I said, "I will find out." And so there you go, I've caught you up in the conversation. You heard my answer. To me, it's this simple and this obvious. Younger men who watch my channel, which are ages typically 15, I know it goes all the way to like 15 to age 32 is the main demographic, but specifically who we're hearing from the most in the comment section is ages 15 to 27, 28. That's most of who's telling their experience and sharing their fears and their anxieties based on hair loss. So if that is ultimately the voice of the channel, and that's the demographic and that's the psychology to which I'm speaking, then ultimately, yes, between that ages, it's very obvious. Guys are looking at their hair changing, whether they're actually going bald or not. They may just have a Norwood 1 or Norwood 2, But they think that that definitely means that they're going to go bald, and it doesn't. And then they therefore fear that they're not going to be able to have sex. Birds and the bees. It's that obvious. That's the fear. And you know, even the follow-up question, how has hair loss affected you so far? Ultimately, the fear of losing your hair and therefore not being able to have sex, that fear itself is how people's life has been affected more than anything. And I know people want to respond to that, but ultimately I already know the response. You know what I'm going to say. We all know men in their early 20s that have lost all their hair on top, and they shave it off and they work out, and they have no trouble finding dates. They have no trouble finding attractive girls. No trouble, because they know what to actually focus on. But I, despite that truth, and despite me reminding everyone of that, ultimately, I think this whole channel, ultimately the fundamental thing that it's built on is, guys are afraid that if they lose their hair, they won't be able to have sex, especially when they're younger, especially during their 20s. Yeah, as they're looking to the near future, they're thinking, okay, this is prime time for this to happen. Or if you were like me, you know, growing up as a religious person, and you still are, which I still am, and therefore it wasn't about, you know, trying to be a player. For me, it was about finding a wife. And some of you fall in that category. Most of you aren't. Most of you are actually atheist. The majority of you are atheist. Only some of you are religious people to the extent that therefore this isn't about how many one-night stands or how many girls. It's about finding a wife. So if you're of the minority that falls in that category, I can relate to you there. That was me. That is me. Granted, I've been married for a decade. But ultimately, I think this is something I haven't really talked much about, even though it's been so obvious. You fear not being able to have sex. But the irony, no matter what your agenda is, whether it's to be a player or to find your wife, ultimately, it's very obvious. It's all based on the confidence. So that whole thing about how has hair loss affected your life so far, the fear of hair loss itself hurts your confidence. Not the hair loss, the fear of that hurts your confidence. And I again redirect you to the 20-year-old guy with Norwood 5 who shaves his head, works out, is confident, knows what his abilities are, knows what he's good at, knows what he's bad at, is funny, knows how to talk to people, has a good personality, learns how to get that personality based on the confidence. And it's the opposite of the guy who fears losing his hair and therefore has less of a personality because he doesn't feel good about it. This other guy says, okay, well, I'm now going to be the buff guy. I'll be the bald guy, but I'm also the more masculine guy. And that screams confidence. That is the mating call. A bald head, confidence, working out. It's so obvious to me. But ultimately, I want to officially recognize, if it weren't for the fear of not being able to have sex because you're going bald, how many people would not watch my videos? How many subscribers would I not have? I think absolutely, undeniably, the reason I can have, how many is it, 5,800 subscribers now? I think it's ultimately based on the fear of not having sex. I really truly believe that. However, Nick Schell does not fear being wrong. Nick Schell is emotionally intelligent. Therefore, the fear of being wrong, nope, I don't fear being wrong. The only thing, if I did fear something, would actually be being a hypocrite, saying one thing and living another. So ultimately, what I want you to know is, since I don't fear being wrong, what I want to point out is, if I'm wrong, then tell me. You know, because I'm all about generalizations and patterns and reducing people to psychology. If I'm wrong that most of you ultimately fear not having sex because you're going bald, if I'm wrong about that, I definitely want you to let me know. But most importantly, I want to let you to let me know why that's not the big thing that you're fearing. And I want to know what is the thing instead. And I'm going to ask you to leave that in the comment section, because from there, I can evolve my channel. You know, that's what it's all about. It's about this evolution. Just like when people say, Nick, you look better with your head shaved anyway. Why don't you just keep it that way? But again, people like to see change. People like to see character growth. Not only mine, which I've definitely evolved as a video host of this channel over the years, but you have also changed as my viewers as well, and we learn from each other by this engagement. So if it's not fear of sex, fear of not having sex because you're going bald, ultimately what is the big thing? What would give a guy like me so much credibility as some random guy with a YouTube channel to be able to gather this many people about a topic? What is the draw if it's not, oh no, I'm going bald and no one's wanting to have sex with me? If I'm wrong, tell me. Yes, I'll assume that I am wrong, that's fine. But tell me what the actual fundamental issue is in the comment section right here.